Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 6th chapter, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada.
For he who is confident in his mind, he is the best of friends. But for one who has failed to do so, his very mind will be the greatest enemy.
This mind, we are talking of the mind, and the whole yoga system means to make the mind our friend. The mind in material contact, just like a person in drunkard condition, his mind is yearning. There is a nice verse in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Krishna bhuliya jeev bhogavan chapare. Pasete maya tare japutiya ghar. The mind, I am the spirit soul, part and parcel of the Supreme Lord. As soon as the mind is contaminated, I rebel because I have got little independence. Why shall I serve Krishna or God? I am God. It is simply a dictation from the mind. And the whole situation turns. He is under false impression, illusion, and the whole life is spoiled. And who has failed to do so, if we fail to conquer the mind, we are trying to conquer so many things, empire. But if we fail to conquer our mind, then even if we conquer an empire, that is a failure. His very mind will be the greatest enemy. God.
For one who has conquered the mind, the super soul is already reached, for he has attained tranquility. To such a man, happiness and distress, heat and cold, honor and dishonor, are all the same.
That one.
A person is said to be established in self-realization and is called a yogi or mystic when he is fully satisfied by virtue of acquired knowledge and realization. Such a person is situated in transcendence and is self-controlled. He sees everything, whether it be pebbles, stones, or gold, as the same.
Yes. When the mind is in equilibrium, then this position comes. Pebbles, stones, or gold, the same value. Go on.
Purport. Book knowledge without realization of the Supreme Truth is useless. This is said as follows in the Padma Purana.
Yes, Padma Purana. There are 18 Puranas. There are men are conducted in three qualities. Modes of goodness, modes of passion, and modes of ignorance. To reclaim all these conditioned souls in different varieties of life, there are presentation of the Puranas. The 6 Puranas are meant for the persons who are in the modes of goodness, And six Puranas are meant for the persons who are in the modes of passion. And the six Puranas who are in the modes of ignorance, those Puranas are meant for them. This Padma Purana is meant for the persons who are in the modes of goodness. In Vedic rituals, you find so many differences of ritualistic performances. It is due to different kinds of men. Just like you have heard that Vedic literature, there is a ritualistic ceremony offering goat sacrifice in the presence of goddess Kali. But this Purana, Markandeya Purana, is meant for the persons who are in the modes of ignorance. Just like a person is attached to eat meat. Now, if all of a sudden, if he is instructed that meat eating is not good, or a person is attached to drink liquor, if he at once said that liquor is not good, he cannot accept. Therefore, in the Puranas you will find, all right, if you want to eat meat, you just worship goddess Kali and sacrifice a goat before the goddess and you can eat meat. You cannot eat meat or flesh by purchasing from the slaughterhouse as butcher's house. You have to eat in this way. That means restriction. Because if you want to perform the sacrifice before the goddess of Kali, there is a certain date, there is a certain paraphernalia you have to arrange for that, and that puja, that worship is allowed on the dark moon night. So dark moon night means once in a month. And the mantras are chanted in this way. The goat is advised that you are sacrificing your life before the goddess Kali. So you get immediately promoted to have a human form of life. Actually it happens. Because to come to the standard of human form of life, one living entity has to pass through so many evolutionary processes. But the goat who agrees or who is by force sacrificed before the goddess Kali, he gets immediate promotion to the human form of life. And if the mantra says that you have got the right to kill this man who is sacrificing. Mansa. Mansa means that he will also eat his flesh next month. So in this way, the man who is sacrificing will come to his senses while eating this flesh. Then I'll have to repay with my flesh. Why should I do this job? Is it? The whole idea is to restrain him. So there are different kinds of Puranas, 18 Puranas. Because the whole Vedic literature means to claim all kinds of men. Not that those who are meat eaters or those drunkards, they are rejected. No. Everyone is accepted. Why there? But there is just like you go to a doctor, he'll prescribe different medicine according to the different disease. Not that he has got one disease, one medicine, whoever comes and offers that medicine. No. That is real treatment. Gradually, gradually. But in the Sattvic Purana, they are meant for immediately worshipping the Supreme Personality of Godhead. There is no gradual process. But gradually, one who comes to this state, he is advised So Padma Purana is one of the Puranas in the modes of goodness. What does it say? God.
It says in the Padma Purana, no one can understand the transcendental nature of the name, form, qualities, and pastimes of Sri Krishna through his materially contaminated senses. Only when one becomes spiritually saturated by transcendental service to the Lord are the transcendental name, form, quality, and pastimes of the Lord revealed to him.
Yes, this is very important. Now, Krishna, we are accepting Krishna as the Supreme Lord. Now, how we accept Krishna as the Supreme Lord? Because it is stated in the Vedic literature, just like in the Brahma Sangita, Ishara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha. Imagination. Those who are in the modes of passion and ignorance, they are imagining the form of God. And when they are confused, they say, oh, there is no personal God. It is all impersonal or void. That is frustration. But actually, God has got form. Why not? The Vedanta says, janmātasya jataha. The Supreme Absolute Truth is that from whom or from which everything emanates. Now, we have got forms, so we have also must have been. Not only we, there are different kinds of forms of the living entities. Where from they come? Where from this form is originated? This is very common sense question. If God is not a person, then how his sons become person? If your father is not a person, how you become a person? This is a very common sense question. If my father has not a form, where from I get this form? People imagine, because when they are frustrated, when they see that this form is troublesome, therefore God must be formless. That is an opposite conception of this form. But Brahma Sangita says, no, God has form, but He is Sachidananda Vigraha. Ishara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha. Sat Chit Ananda. Sat means Sitana. Sat means Sitana, Chit means knowledge, and Ananda means pleasure. So, God has form, but He has got a form which is full of pleasure, full of knowledge and eternal. Now compare your body. Your body is neither eternal, nor full of pleasure, nor full of knowledge. Therefore, God has form, but He has got a different form. But as soon as we speak of form, we think the form must be like this, that we opposite, no form. That's no knowledge. That is not knowledge. Therefore, the Padma Purana says that you cannot understand about the form, name, quality, paraphernalia of God with these material senses. Atah Sri Krishna Namadi Navabed Grayam Indriya. By your sense speculation, because your senses are imperfect, how you can speculate on the Supreme Perfect? That is not possible. Then, how it is possible? Sevan Mukhi Hiji Bhadu. If you train your senses, if you purify your senses, that purified sense will help you to see God. Just like if you have got some disease, cataract, on your eyes. That does not mean you cannot see because your eyes are suffering from cataract. You cannot see. That does not mean there is nothing to be seen. You cannot. Similarly, you cannot just conceive what is the form of God now. But if your cataract is removed, you can see. That is required. Premanjana Srita Bhakti Vilochanena Santas Sadaiva Hridayesu Vilokayanti. If Brahma Sangita says that devotees whose eyes are anointed with the love of God ointment, such persons within his heart seeing God Krishna always 24 hours, not that. So you require to purify your senses. Then you will be able to understand what is the form of God, what is the name of God, what is the quality of God, what is the paraphernalia of God. God has everything. That these things are discussed in Vedic literature. Just like Apanipada Javanagrihita. It is said the God has no hands or legs, but he can accept anything you offer. God has no eyes and ears, but he can see everything and he can hear everything. So these are contradictions. That means whenever we speak of seeing, we think somebody must have eyes like this. That is our material concept. God has seen eyes, he can see you in the darkness. You cannot see in the darkness. So he has got a different eye. God can hear. If you are, God is in his kingdom, which is millions and millions of miles away, but if you are talking something, whispering, conspiracy, he can hear. Because he is sitting within you. So you cannot avoid God seeing and God hearing or God's presence. Just like in the Bhagavad Gita it is said, patram pusvam phalam tuyam jumi bhaktya prajachati taya bhaktya prahitam asnami prajatatmana. If somebody offers me flower, fruits, vegetables, milk, with devotion and love, I accept and eat. Now, how he is eating, that you cannot see in the present, but he is eating. That we are experiencing daily. We are offering Krishna according to the ritualistic process, and you see the taste of the food is changed immediately. That is practical. He eats, but because he is poor, he does not eat like us. Just like if I give you a plate of foodstuff, you finish. But God is not hungry, but he eats. He eats and keeps the things as it is. Purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vasishtate. God is so full that he can take the all the foodstuff that you offer, still it remains as it is. He can eat with his eyes. That is stated in the Brahma Sangita. Angani yasya sakalendriya vritti mandri. Every part of the limb of the body of God has got all the potencies of Ananda. Just like you can see with your eyes, but you cannot eat with your eyes. But God, if he simply sees the foodstuff you have offered, that he is eating. So these things cannot be understood at the present moment. Therefore, this Padma Puran says that only when one becomes spiritually saturated by the transcendental service to the Lord, then are the transcendental name, form, quality and pastimes of the Lord revealed. You cannot understand by your own endeavor, but God reveals to you. Just like if you want to see just now the sun, it is now darkness. If you say, oh, I have got a very strong torchlight, come on, I shall show you this sunlight, sun. You cannot show. But when the sun rises out of its own will, in the morning you can see. Similarly, you cannot see God by your endeavor, because your senses are all nonsense. Yeah. You have to purify your senses and you have to wait for the time when God will be pleased to reveal Himself before you. That is the problem. You cannot challenge, "Ah, my dear God, my dear Krishna, please come." I shall see. No, God is not your order supplier, your servant. So when He will be pleased, you will see Him. So our process is how to please Him so that He will be revealed to me. That is the real process. You cannot, therefore, then mistaking a nonsense a God. Because they cannot see God, anybody says that I am God and accept it. But they do not know what is God. Somebody says that I am searching after the truth. But you must know what is the truth. Otherwise, how you will search out truth? Suppose if you want to purchase gold, you must theoretically know, or at least some experience, what is gold. Otherwise people will cheat you. So these people are being cheated, accepting so many rascals as God. Because they do not know what is God. Anyone comes, "Oh, I am God." And the rascal, he's rascal, and the man who says that I am God, he is also rascal. The rascal society, and one rascal is accepted God. God is not like that. One has to qualify himself to see God, to understand God. That is Krishna consciousness. If you engage yourself in the service of the Lord, then you will be qualified to see God. Otherwise it is not possible.
This Bhagavad Gita is the science of Krishna consciousness. Nobody can become Krishna conscious simply by mundane scholarship.
Yes. Simply because you have got some titles, MA, PhD, BSc, you will understand Bhagavad Gita. It is not possible. This is not transcendental science. It requires different senses to understand. And that sense you have to create, you have to purify by rendering service. Otherwise, great scholars, like so many doctors and PhDs, they mistake what is Krishna. They cannot understand. It is not possible. Therefore, Krishna comes as He is. Adhupisannabhyatma. Although He is unborn, He comes to make us know how God is. God.
One must be fortunate enough to associate with a person who is in pure consciousness. A Krishna conscious person has realized knowledge by the grace of Krishna.
Yeah, by the grace of Krishna, not by academic qualification. We have to acquire the grace of Krishna. Then we can understand Krishna. Then we can see Krishna. Then we can talk with Krishna. Then we can do everything. He is a person. He is the Supreme Person. That is the Vedic injunction. Nitya nityanam chetana chetananam. He is the Supreme Person or the Supreme Eternal. We are all eternal. However, now we being encased within this body, we are meeting birth and death. But actually we have no birth and death. We are eternal spirit soul. And according to my work, according to my desire, I am transmigrating from one kind of body to another body, another body, another body. This is going on. Actually, I have no birth and death. This is explained in the Bhagavad Gita, in the second chapter you have read. Na jayate na mriyate va. The living entity never takes birth or never dies. Similarly, God is also eternal. You are also eternal. When you establish your eternal relationship with the eternal, complete eternal, nitya nityanam, Chetana Chetanama. He is the supreme living entity amongst these living entities. He is the supreme eternal amongst eternals. So, by Krishna consciousness, by purifying your senses, this knowledge will come and you will see God.
A Krishna conscious person has realized knowledge by the grace of Krishna because he is satisfied with pure devotional service. By realized knowledge, one becomes perfect. By such perfect knowledge, one can remain steady in his convictions. But by academic knowledge, one is easily deluded and is confused by apparent contradictions. It is the realized soul who is actually self-controlled, because he is surrendered to Krishna. He is transcendental because he has nothing to do with mundane scholarship.
Even one is illiterate, even he does not know what is ABCD, he can realize God, provided he engages himself in this submissive, transcendental, loving service. And one may be very learned, high scholar, but he cannot realize God. God is not subjected to any material condition. He is Supreme Spirit. Similarly, the process of realizing God is also not subjected to any material condition. It is not that because you are poor man, you cannot realize God. Or because you are very rich man, therefore you shall realize God. No. Because you are uneducated, therefore you cannot realize God. No, that is not. Because you are highly educated, therefore you can realize God. No, that is not. He is unconditioned. Apratihata savaipunsa paro dharma. In the Bhagavad it is said, that is first class religious principle. Bhagavad does not mention that this Hindu religion is first class, or Christian religion is first class, or Mohammedan religion is first class, or any other religion. We have created so many religions. But Bhagavad says that religious principle is first class. Which one? Savai pungsa paro dharma jato bhakti radokhaje. That religion which helps you to advance your devotional service, the love of God. That's all. That is the definition of first class. Now, we do not analyze that this religion is first class, that religion is last class. Of course, according to that, I have told you that there are three qualities in the material world. So according to the quality, the religious conception is also created. But the purpose of religion is to understand God and to learn how to love God. That is the purpose. Any religious system, if it teaches you how to love God, then it is first class. Otherwise it is useless. You may prostitute your religious principles very rigidly and very nicely, but your love of God is need. Your love of matter is simply enhancing. That is no religion. According to Bhagavad Bhadi, savai punsa parvo dharma jato bhakti radokhaje. Apratihata. That religious system has no cause. Without any impediment. If you can reach such system of religious principle, then you will find that you are happy in all respects. Otherwise, there is no possibility. Savai pungsa paro dharma jato bhakti radokhaje. Radhokhaje, God's another name is Adhokhaje. Adhokhaje means conquers all materialistic attempt to see God. Adhokhaje. Akhaje means experimental knowledge. You cannot understand God by experimental knowledge. No. Well, you have to learn in a different way. That means by submissive, the oral deception and rendering transcendental loving service. Then you can understand. So any religious principle which teaches and helps you to develop your love of God without any force. I love God because He supplies me very nice things for my sense gratification. That is not love. Oh, without any love. God is great. God is my Father. It is my duty to love. That. No exchange. Oh, God gives me my daily bread, therefore I love God. No. Daily bread God gives it to the animals, cats and dogs. That is, God is Father of everyone. He supplies food to everyone. So that is not love. Love is without reason. Even God does not supply me daily bread, I love God. That is love. That is love. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says like that. Atmishtabha padala paankunastama. Either you embrace me, or you trample me down on your feet, or you never come before me, I become broken-hearted without seeing. Still I love. That is pure love. When we come to that stage of loving God, then we find all full of pleasure. As God is full of pleasure, you are also full of pleasure. That is the perfection. Wow.
A person is said to be still further advanced when he regards all, the honest well-wisher, friends and enemies, the envious, the pious, the sinner, and those who are indifferent and impartial, with an equal mind.
Yes, this is the sign of advancement. Because here in this material world, the calculation of friend and enemy, everything is in the relationship of this body, all sense gratification. But realization of God or the absolute truth, there is no such material consideration. Another point is that here all conditioned souls, they are under illusion. Suppose a doctor goes to a patient, he is under convulsion, he is talking nonsense. That does not mean he refused to treat him. He treats him as friend. Also, although the patient calls him by ill names, bad names, still he gives him medicine. Lord Jesus Christ said that you hate the sin, not the sinner. Not the sinner. This is very nice. Because sinner is innocent, he is mad. If you hate him, then how you can deliver? Therefore, those who are devotees, those who are really servant of God, they have no hate for anyone. Just like Lord Jesus Christ, when he was being crucified, he was requesting God, my Lord, please excuse them. They do not know what they are doing. This is the position of the devotee. Because they are mad after materialistic way of thinking. So they cannot be hated. Anyone. So this Krishna conscious movement is so nice that there is no question of hating. Everyone is welcome. Please come here. Chant Hare Krishna. Take Krishna Prasad and hear some nice philosophy from Bhagavad Gita and try to rectify your material conditional life. This is the program, Krishna consciousness. Lord Chaitanya introduced this movement. Jare dakho tare kaho Krishna bode. Whoever you meet, wherever you meet, simply try to teach him this Krishna consciousness. Krishna Katha, words from Lord Krishna. You will be happy and they will be happy.
A transcendentalist should always try to concentrate his mind on the Supreme Self. He should live alone in a secluded place and should always carefully control his mind He should be free from desires and possessiveness.
And this is the beginning of transcendental life. This chapter, Lord Krishna is trying to teach the principles of yoga system. So here he begins that a transcendentalist should always try to concentrate his mind on the Supreme Self. Supreme Self means Krishna or Lord. He is the Supreme Self, as I just explained. Nitya Nityanam Chetana Chetanam. He is the Supreme Eternal. He is the Supreme Living Entity. So, the whole yoga system is to concentrate mind on the Supreme Self. We are not Supreme Self, that you can understand. Supreme Self is God. This is Dvaitava, duality. Duality means God is different from me. He is supreme. I am servant. He is great. I am small. He is infinite. I am infinitesimal. This is the relationship. So, because we are infinitesimal, we should concentrate our mind to the infinite, supreme self. Then he should live alone. Alone. This is the most important thing. Alone means not to live with persons who are not Krishna conscious or God conscious. That is alone. He should live alone in a secluded place. Secluded place, there are in the jungle, in the forest, it is very secluded place. But in this age, it is very difficult to go to the jungle and find out the secluded place. The secluded place is that where simply God consciousness is taught. That is secluded place. That is secluded place. Then, and should always carefully control his mind. How to control the mind? Just fix up your mind to the Supreme Self or Krishna, not anything else. Savai mana Krishna padarvinda. Then the other day, as I said, if you keep your mind always seated by Krishna, Krishna is just like light, sun. So there is no question of darkness occupying the mind. There is no possibility, just like the sunlight, there is no possibility of darkness. Similarly, if you keep Krishna on your mind always, this maya or illusion cannot reach them. She will be unable to reach them. That is the problem. He should be free from desires and possessiveness. The whole material disease is that I want to possess and desire. Whatever is lost, I lament for it, and whatever we haven't got, we desire for it. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma, one who is actually God conscious, Krishna conscious, he has no desire for material possession. He has only desire how to serve Krishna. That means his desire is purified. This desire is, you cannot give up desire. That is not possible. You are a living entity. You must have desire. But our desire is at the present moment is contaminated. I desire to satisfy my senses by material possession. But if you desire for Krishna, this desire for material possession will automatically vanish. Gone.
To practice yoga, one should go to a secluded place.
This is the prescription, how to practice yoga. In your country, the yoga practice is very popular. There are many so-called yoga societies. But here is the prescription given by the Supreme Lord, how to practice yoga.
One should go to a secluded place and should make kusha grass on the ground and then cover it with a deer skin and a soft cloth. The seat should neither be too high nor too low, and should be situated in a sacred place.
The yogi should then sit on it very firmly and should practice yoga by controlling the mind and the senses, purifying the heart and fixing the mind on one point. Purport. Sacred place refers to places of pilgrimage. In India, the yogis, the transcendentalists, or the devotees all leave home and reside in sacred places such as Prayag, Mathura, Vrindavan, Rishikesh, Hardwar, and practice yoga there.
Suppose you have to find out a sacred place. In this age, how many people is prepared to find out a sacred place? For his livelihood, he has to live in a congested city. Where is the question of sacred place? If you don't find a sacred place, then how you can practice yoga? That is the first prescription. Therefore, this bhakti yoga system is the sacred place, is this temple. You live here, it is nirguna, it is transcendental. The basic injunction is that the city is the place of passion and the forest is the place of goodness and the temple is transcendental. If you live in a city or a town, that is a passionate place. And if you don't want to live in a passionate place, you go to a forest, that is place of goodness. But a temple, a God's temple, is above this passion and goodness. Therefore, temple is the only secluded place for this age. You cannot go in a secluded place in the forest, it is impossible. And if you make a show of yoga practice in a so-called class and indulge in all kinds of nonsense thing. That is not yoga practice. Here is the prescription how to practice yoga. Go on.
A sacred place is where the sacred rivers like the Yamuna and the Ganges flow. Any bank on the river Ganges or Yamuna is naturally sacred. One should select a place which is secluded and undisturbed. The so-called yoga societies in big cities may be successful in earning material benefit, but they are not at all suitable for the actual practice of yoga. One who is not self-controlled and whose mind is not undisturbed cannot practice meditation. Therefore,
the Brihad Naradiya Purana.
Therefore, in the Brihad Naradiya Puranam, it is said that in the Kali Yuga, the present Yuga or age, when people in general are short living, slow in spiritual realization, and always disturbed by various anxieties, the best means of spiritual realization is to chant the holy name of the Lord. In this age of quarrel and hypocrisy, the only means of deliverance is to chant the holy name of the Lord. There is no other way to success.
Yes. That is the prescription in the Brihad Naradiya Purana. Harinnama, 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 eva kelam, kevalam, kalo nasiva, 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 gatidarnatha. Harinnama, simply chant the holy name of the Lord, and that is the only process of self-realization or concentration or meditation, and there is no other alternative, no other alternative, no other alternative. Other practices will not be feasible. And it is so nice that even a child can take part in it. This is universal. If you prescribe yoga practice to a child, it is impossible. It is not acceptable by everyone. But here is a process introduced by the Brihad Naradiya Purana. Just chant Hare Krishna, it can be taken part by anyone, even a child, even an illiterate, even a fool, even a sinner. Everyone can take part. This is universal. Janvari.